there's a whole list of consultations. In fact, I've got a full detail which I've sent to your team. The days of the consultations, the villages who were consulted, the people who turned up. In fact, if you look at the matrix that I provided, the 6 or 7 villages who are now signing the petition, they were also part of the consultation, not only once, but many times. So they've been consulted, the company, the Ministry for Environment, the Ministry for Lands and Mineral Resources, they've been constantly in contact with the villages. It's just that I think somebody just went to them, and I've been told some villages actually approached us, I still have to get the written confirmation, that what they were asked to sign was on a blank paper. Some of the people went down, and got them signed on a blank paper saying that it's something to do with the river dredging. They never told them. Some people have approached us, and I've asked my team to go and get written statements from them. That some people are coming to tell us that they thought they were signing for something else, then they ended up with their names ended up on the petition. So I think it's all a very convoluted kind of, you know, a dodgy way of doing these things. This is the thing, because when we do the consultations, we take the full minutes, and it's not only done by us. There's the Thirangani Koros are there, the what do you call that provincial development officers are there, the PAE office is represented, so all of them are there, Ministry of Environment is there, and none of these concerns were raised. In fact, until now, nobody's complained to our ministry that some sort of damage has been done to their fishing ground, etc. And there's regular tests done. In fact, I have to check on that, but every 3 months, the team goes down to check the water around it. We're doing that for the mines, the mining exploration in Bua. Every 3 months we go and test the water, test the fish. It's all clear. I don't want to see. That was about land bank. When somebody wants to deposit their vacant land, so landowners want to deposit their vacant land in the land bank, 60% of them sign and tell us that, okay, we want to deposit it, and we go and look for their prospective leases. When that doesn't eventuate, 60% of the people can again sign for a withdrawal. That's what it is. Here, when the consultations are done, if somebody is given a mining or exploration license, right, it will be very inconvenient and uneconomical for the mine to come bring all the equipment one day and tomorrow they are told that you can't do it. So we do it all beforehand. Before the license is given, for the duration of the license, they cannot be disturbed. If they breach any condition of the license, we'll take it back. So there's two different things. Land bank is a different category altogether, and this is an exploration license.